years ago in March.
About a year ago.
Less than a year
ago. A couple of years ago.
A few months ago.
Last year in
August. 3 years ago.
About 3 years ago.
Less than a year
ago.
Second
week of high school.
7-ish months ago.
Just over a year ago.
At the end of September.
Almost 2 years ago.
Last year in February.
Something happened.
A moment. I can't really put my finger on it.
Yet, there it is.
Like a picture. A place.
A person.
A feeling.
A snapshot.
Shh. In my head.
What was me.
Isn't me.
All gone.
What am I going to do about it?
Probably nothing.
There's only one thing.
For sure.
The person I was.
Isn't here anymore.
It changed me.
In important ways.
I think about other people more.
If I don't cry, I don't think about it now.
I still wonder if I should say anything. I don't know how things are gonna work out.
I want them both to be happy.
I'm the first person in my family to say this.
Living your life is important.
I'm not afraid of things as much. My family wants to know.
It's hard to say it out loud.
I'm just more myself.
I'm not like that anymore.
I'm different.
I'm more relaxed.
More
me.
My time was running wild, a million dead-end streets, and every time I thought I got it made, it seemed the taste was not so sweet. So I turned myself to face me, but I've never caught a glimpse how the others must see the faker. I'm much too fast to take that test.
Changes.
Turn and face the strain.
Changes.
Don't wanna be a richer man.
Changes.
Turn and face the strain.
Changes.
It's gonna have to be a different man. Sides, but never leave the stream of warm and permanent sand. So the days float through my eyes, but still the days seem the same. And these children that you spit on as they try to change their worlds are immune to your consultations. They're quite aware of what they're going through.
Changes.
Turn and face the strain.
Changes.
Don't tell them to grow up out of it.
Changes.
Turn and face the strain.
Changes.
Where's your shame? You've left us up to her next to it. Time may change me. You can't twist time. Strange fascination.
What's up, slut?
When I think back, it seems like it happened really slowly. But now I know it's just a few seconds. And so you don't miss anything, here you go. Everyone looked at Jesse. June, the girl he'd been talking to, she was already out the door. Zoe, Dina, and Hugh, they all looked up from their phones and looked at Jesse. And when the bell rang, they went off to class. And Tara behind us, she looked at Jesse and said,
"Oh my God."
And when the bell rang, she left. and Brett with the basketball. He took one of his earbuds out and looked confused. And then when the bell rang, he put the earbud back in, noticed that Crazy Eyes was standing in front of him, and he went to class. And then Crazy Eyes...
Wait, are you calling me Crazy Eyes?
I never named names, Laura.
But that's like a thing, right? You all...
Anyways, so Crazy Eyes looked at Jesse, and then she noticed that Brian was looking at her, and she looked mortified and went to class. Devon and Christine sitting down by the lockers. Christine looked completely disgusted at Jesse, and she just ran and went down the hallway. And Devon said something to Jesse as she was chasing after Christine. And Ben and Lady by the lockers, they looked at Jesse and then looked at each other, and Ben said,
"Gotta be a virgin with a game like that."
And they went off. And Al and Skeeter, they both looked at Jesse, and Al said,
"That was not cool."
And Skeeter said,
"No shit."
And Shay, she just kept looking at Jesse. And Jesse gave an angry butt look, and she just walked by and shoulder checked him. And while all this was happening, Reggie was saying something to me, but I couldn't really hear him. And all together, it went like this.
It's just wild.
I know. Christine,
what,
why are you so
dumb? What's up?
What? That was not my fault.
Asshole. Christine, wait! She was the one who called me first, yeah, but like, it's like she was talking to me, but there's like something else going on. I'm like, I don't know if it was like something going on with her or if it was like something that like maybe I said, like. Karen, you okay?
What?
You're right?
Did you hear Jesse?
No. What did he say?
He was. Actually, never mind. We should head off to class.
Okay, it's been 10 minutes. I think after 15, we're legally allowed to leave.
I'm not sure that rule applies to a program like this. Yeah, stare, Jesse. Real mature.
All right. Keep talking today, guys. I'm making you guys so
cool. Oh, you're so cool.
You know, as a matter of fact, darling.
Don't call me darling.
Oh, I'm sorry. I offend you.
You're disinfensive enough, you piece of trash.
You're gonna regret that when I'm an Olympian.
All right, settle down there, Ice Princess. It's just figures.
Right,
sound your
mind
like you're one to talk.
And I was talking to you.
I took my team to state in basketball 2 years in a row. Thank you very much.
Right, I mean saving.
And what are you doing this year?
I'm here for probably the same reasons everyone else is. I mean, even if there was an independent basketball team, I would never join, so.
I hear jealousy, Brian.
Of an Olympic hopeful in the category of gayest sport ever? Don't think so.
Could we not use gay as a derogatory term?
At least I don't play with balls all day, fag.
Okay, that was kind of funny, but there's nothing gayer than figure skating.
I'm actually gayer than figure skating.
Good
skating.
Morning,
you know. It's nice to see all of you. Hope you're all getting back in the swing of things. Yes, no.
No.
All right, so let's jump in with our next assignment. We're gonna be doing college essays! Woo! The joys of expository writing. Your buzzing assures me you could not be more excited.
Yeah, Miss M.
Yeah.
Some of us are already planning on going to college.
That's a great point, Al.
Yeah, I know. So why should I have to write something for something I'm never going to do?
That is a great question, Al. And I have an answer. I have to have an answer, or they'll fire me. Thank you, Skeeter. Look, essay writing is easily one of the most valuable skills you will ever learn. I mean, it's communication in its highest form. Plus, this essay focuses on something you all know better than anyone else. Yourselves! So, assuming the last two things I said are true, combined with the fact that I love and care for each of you as individuals, I can think of no better way for you to spend your time. Yes, Link?
Mr. Willard said that algebra was the most valuable skill we'd ever learned.
Well, sure. I've seen all of you take out your phones and willingly write to each other, but I've never seen any of you do equations just for fun. Plus, I mean, who really likes
math? I like math.
Okay, so to review. One, you'll write a 1 to 2 page essay. Two, the essay will focus on a transition period in your life. This means something that happened to you personally and how it affected you, how you see the world. This is to prepare you for the inevitable college essay starter, the moment when everything changed in all of its cliche glory. Easy, right? Yeah?
All right, go to lunch early. Now you're going to pay anyway. Enjoy the rest of your day, every minute of it. Over 50% of you admit to texting and driving, and 16 teens die every day in motor vehicle accidents. Today could be your last. Drive safe, kids.
I'm not doing
it. Oh, such a rebel.
I'm not even going to college.
You don't know that.
I think it's illegal.
The food?
You're an idiot, you know that?
No, no, like making us write something against who we are.
Who put a rant?
Well, it's like if somebody asked us what it's like to be Jewish.
You are insane.
I got fired for that one.
I didn't know college was religion.
Yeah, well, you don't know much, do you?
You're not serious, are you?
Just think about it. All these people, the elders, worshiping at the altars of 4 more years of servitude and spending thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars, to indoctrinate us into the society of thinking.
All about the money.
The society of thinking. Did you just think of that?
Yes.
That was outstanding.
Thank you.
You're both idiots.
Thank you.
Oh my god.
Oh, hey, look, it's the freshman.
Guys, look.
So, I recognize Brendan's sister, but who's the one with all the hair?
Oh, that's Zoe. Her dad's a producer with 20th Century Fox or something. They're filthy rich, yeah.
Seriously?
It's disgusting.
It's life. Some people are more fortunate than others and some aren't. And some are perfectly happy doing crystal meth and dying in a gutter.
That's
not happiness.
Maybe not to you.
I'm probably funnier and better looking than any of them, but they're more likely to end up on SNL because of nepotism. Who? Like Nicolas Cage, or should I say Nicolas Coppola?
It's Coppola, baby.
Hey.
Coppola.
Hey. Do you guys think it's fair that she's asking us to write a college essay?
Oh no, you actually have to work.
Well, we're freshmen.
Life's not fair, bitch. Stop. It's how the program works, guys. They group us all together at cut corners. As long as we fill the standards, they really don't care.
But how are you going to learn properly?
That's because school isn't for learning, little one. It's for keeping you regular and off the streets while mommy and daddy ignore you.
Welcome. Welcome to the Society of Thinking.
I seriously hate you guys.
Nothing.
He at you again?
No, it's just you hear certain words and certain
certain things, and I hate to be one of those triggered people, but
if you make me feel better.
Except it won't change anything.
Except your attitude, that's everything.
Except I'll be panting and sweaty. I'll take a pen and paper. Thanks.
I like it panting and sweaty. Whatever, be a lizard.
Did you read what I wrote?
What?
Last night. I sent it to you.
Oh, no, not yet.
Oh.
Read it to me now.
No, it's fine. You're writing.
Read it to me now.
Fine. October. Cold. Alone. Even in the street, I can see my breath. Dark. Alone. He was, as he's always been, bad for me, bad to me, just bad. I want out, but I can't call because you're away. So I live inside this dark thought. Night. Alone.
You're not alone.
I know, but I was.
It was temporary.
I know that. Stop. Just... I love you.
I love you too, but I have to go.
I know.
What do you have to eat? I don't know. Hang on. Salmon and rice? Stop. Butter. That's very sexy. Oh, no, don't tell me. You, my friend, are championship material.
Whatever.
So, what's disturbing your Ken?
My what?
Ken.
My Ken?
Yeah.
Are you kidding me? Who actually talks like that?
The society of thinking.
Hilarious. What's disturbing my Ken is that she hasn't returned my text in a week.
Ah.
What?
My thing?
No, what's ah mean?
Nothing. Just, you know, you can do so much better than crazy eyes.
She does not have crazy eyes.
She's literally crazy. So whether or not you see it, there's still technically crazy eyes. Hello? What, you just not gonna talk to me anymore?
I just don't want to talk to you about this, okay?
Fine. I mean, you saw her. She was carted off in front of everyone.
Everyone has bad days.
Yeah, well, my bad days don't end in a crazy house.
Well, gold star for Brian.
She's a mentally deranged
troubled person, okay? Shut up, I don't want to talk to you about that.
Fine! You got no chance, buddy. You're a loser.
Thanks.
Come on, I mean, not like a loser-loser. It's just like... Like, you're the type of person that she should probably date, but never like someone she'd, like, actually date, you know?
All too well.
Hey, it's the truth. I mean, even I'm too cool for you. But you seduce me with cookies.
Well, at least I have cookies.
Yeah, a loser with cookies. But something else is bothering you.
I mean, there's always Jesse, right?
Oh. Yeah, whatever.
Whatever? Did you listen to him today?
Yeah, but like... I'm better than him, you know? You just gotta start tuning him out.
Tune him out? You almost got into a fight with him, dude.
Yeah, but that was different.
Wait, did you hear him in the hallway this morning when he was talking to June?
What?
When he called her a slut.
Oh, is that what that was?
Yeah. God, it really bothered Karen, like...
Just sleep with her already.
No, that'd be weird. That'd be like sleeping with my sister or something. Maybe that's why it bugged me so much, like... It bothered Karen that much, and she's had a whole year's worth of high school experience dealing with, like, guys and bullshit like that, you know what I mean? And my sister was, like, right there in the hallway, too, and, man, I don't know what she thinks about all this stuff.
Well, that's the way it is. Some guys are just like that. Eat another cookie.
I can't eat anymore.
How can you say that? That's, like, the same.
Where do you put it?
No idea.
Do you want to see my dress?
Sure. Need any help in there?
No, I'm good.
Are you sure?
Yep.
You sure?
Yep.
Laney, you're beautiful.
You sound surprised.
Well, you're... No, I mean, you're...
This doesn't sound like it's going anywhere good.
No, you're beautiful, that's all.
Thank you.
What?
Nothing.
That's not the nothing phase.
I wanted you to say that.
What?
That I'm beautiful.
You are.
Well, yeah, but I wanted to hear it, so I got you to say it.
Happens all the time.
What?
You know, we say things, do things, so people can say what we want.
That's harsh.
Just saying.
Fine, I'm a bad person.
Didn't say that.
Whatever.
You know, Jesus did it too.
This conversation's officially weird.
Whatever.
So now you're a religious scholar?
Nope. Just saying that Jesus said things in order to persuade people into doing things he wanted them to. Everybody has an agenda, including you.
And Jesus.
Yep.
What are you gonna write for the thing?
For Miss M?
Yeah.
I don't know. I kind of feel like I've been mean my whole life.
I can see that.
How about you?
I don't know. I kind of feel like the moment's now.
Now?
Well, no, not now, but, like, this year? I don't know, like, lately I've just been doing things and, like, seeing them more, like, catching myself wanting to dress up for you. And it's like, I've always been doing these things, but I've never really wondered why, and lately I've just been wondering why I'm doing these things, and I find myself trusting myself more about decisions. Do you think this could be a transition?
I don't know. What would the transition be into?
I have no idea.
Do you have any more food?
Funny.
Are you working on the thing?
Yeah.
What are you doing it on?
The day I met you.
How old?
It's the best thing that ever happened to me.
You're so gay.
You have a problem with it?
No, I mean, it's mostly your story anyways.
Damn right it is.
Are you getting tough with me?
So what if I am? You gonna hit me too?
Yeah, maybe if you're not careful.
Whatever. Have you started yet?
No. It's a bullshit assignment and we can't afford college, so what's the point?
Shut up. You haven't not done a homework assignment since like the second grade. You're literally a super, super stupid.
True, but whatever.
You have something.
No, I don't.
Why don't you just tell me what it is?
I don't know.
Tell me.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What is
okay,
it?
Okay, okay, I was talking about my mom. I have a story. Yeah.
7. You have to do that.
I don't think so.
Please.
I'll think about it.
1 in 6? 1 in 6? Oh my god, you've got to be kidding me. I have never seen anything like that.
Karen, dinner!
In a minute, Mom, I'm doing homework.
Now, Karen.
Fine. Can I go over to my friend's house after dinner? Peggy Sue, my buddy Holly and Cricket.
Got it.
This game isn't fair of the two of you.
Good music is good music.
Okay, try this one.
My generation by two.
How old are you? Like 70?
Like I said.
Good music is good music, whatever.
No, just because it's popular doesn't necessarily mean it's bad. I mean, have you actually listened to Eminem? Lyrical mastery right there.
Alright, this one's for you, plebe.
Oh my god, that's too easy!
Hey now, you're an all-star, get your game on, go play! Hey now, you're a rock star, get the show on, get paid! All that glitters is gold, only shooting stars!
Come on, how did you not know that?
Pop music of the last 30 years is dead, empty, and void of meaning. Just overrated sexual innuendo with Michael Jackson standing on top of the mountain.
You know you can just enjoy stuff, right?
Whatever. I'm hipster. I know what I like.
What are you reading?
Zen and the Art of Archery. Since when are you into archery?
I'm not.
Okay, so forgive us peons, but why are you reading it then?
The book isn't really about archery.
So, is it about Zen, or...
Is Zen like Pilates?
No, Pilates is a health club thing. Zen is meditation.
Oh. So you're meditating now?
No! Zen is about learning how to use your brain.
Oh. Shoot, guess you're up then, Hugh.
Oh, you got me.
No! If you two will stop, I will explain. The book is about these monks. It's a systematic form of meditation to understand themselves and the world. Archery is just a form of their practice. In order to shoot the arrow through the bullseye, they first begin by meditating on the target for a year. Then, they point the arrow at the target without letting go for like another year. Then, in the third year, they actually let go of the arrow and hits the bullseye. First shot.
For realsies?
Yes, Tara. For realsies. The point is, if there's something you want to do, something you want to achieve, you must first bring a clear focus in mind and intend the task and buck up distractions.
Wow. Should we be meditating on Brian?
Disgusting.
I don't even like Brian.
First thing you said when you came to Independent. That guy is cute. Plus, he called you little one. Come on, it's so obvious.
No, he's a distraction. Clear mind, remember?
Clear from what?
Girls, you want some snacks?
No, Mom, hurry homework.
Dude, what? I'm hella hungry.
Are you sure?
Please, I didn't eat lunch today.
Fine, Mother.
Oh, how wonderful. I just picked up some delightful vegan spring rolls. Oh, are we gonna have Lucy and go down again?
Yes, sure, Josie.
Heavens no, that's far too much salt and processed nonsense. Oh, Susie, you look different, new style?
Mom, we have this tape, we don't have a lot of time.
Darling, you need to take better care of your guests. It's not always about you and your books.
You should never call me darling.
You go on and be a brat, but at least Susie likes me, right?
Righto, Mrs. P.
It's actually Miss now.
Oh, right, sorry.
No worries, soldier on, right? So what are we eating?
We used to love chicken noodle.
No, you're plumping up enough as it is. You need to lose weight for pilot season.
I don't even want to do that, though.
Sushi platter sounds great, Miss P. Is that all right with you, Susie?
Sushi's great.
try to be a little bit more like your guests. I'll be right back, girls!
What? I'm hungry. She wants to feed us. Let her be happy. She's probably all bored and lonely anyways.
Nothing, just sometimes harder dealing with all that than the divorce.
Yeah, you're filthy rich now. Such a tragedy.
That's not what I was
trying to say. Oh, and Susie, don't take this the wrong way, but if you ever need help shopping or whatever, I'm happy to take you.
What?
I mean, I know your mom's not around much. I don't mean to be rude, but like, if you want someone to help accent your features, you know, something a little bit more showy, like reel those boys in, right?
Oh my God!
Don't be afraid of it with the right outfit. Your tits could look great.
Mom!
Fern, she likes me. Okay. I'll be right back, girls.
Wow. That was awesome.
I'm so sorry.
It's chill, dude.
No, it's not.
No, I get it. First person she'd call would be my mom, and I do not want that. I just wish you had the courage to be you. And I wish you could understand how scary that is.
Do you guys ever wish we could go to a real school?
No, it's so much more work.
I don't know. Grass is always greener, right? I mean, in theory, they moved me to independence, so I didn't get too stressed with everything that's going on. They said I was dealing with too much change recently or whatever. And I knew I'd get more time for reading, but they're still pushing acting. And I know it's a shoot with my dad, but Hollywood's so superficial. I want to be known for my brains.
Dude, any public school's just as superficial as Hollywood, plus there's more people. At least here, all I have to worry about is that Jesse guy.
Did you used to get bullied for being trans?
Yep, that's why I left.
That's weird. You don't even look trans.
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, you know, my mom just started dressing more butch or whatever. It's not like you, like, look like a dude.
Okay, cool, thanks.
Don't be like that.
Awesome, you too?
No, that's the problem. Awesome, cool, whatever. I don't even care, whatever. I'll just sit here and mope.
You know you're being kind of offensive, right?
But we're not trying to be.
We should be trying to not be.
We're your friends. We care. If we're offensive, it's because we don't know something. Get off your high horse and educate us, or else the world will hate you. And not for being trans, but for being angry and looking for reasons to get angry.
Oh my God, okay? Trans doesn't have to have a look. Everyone thinks that just because Caitlyn Jenner can make herself passable in like a week or whatever. But the fact is, like all human beings, we come in many different shapes and sizes. Some level to pass and look sexy or normal, so to speak, but not everyone's gonna be able to do that. Plus, transition's a journey, so it'll look like many different things over the course of everyone's life. So, there's this whole spectrum of gender and sexuality, and society just needs to shut up and stop caring about what anyone looks like and let us have sex with whoever we want to. And yeah, I'm not 100% out, so sometimes I do try to keep a more feminine appearance for times when, you know, my friend's mom wants to talk about my tits.
I said I was sorry about that.
It's fine, it's not your fault. I know you guys love and support me or whatever, but you can also be really dumb.
Yeah, well, you taught us something today, and the world became a slightly better place.
You're still an ass.
Whatever, you love me.
So, did you, like, come out, or?
Kind of. I asked the girl out, and she said I'm not gay, so I explained I'm a dude, I'm trans, and she said I don't like in-betweeners then, and told everyone.
Dude, rough.
Do you regret it?
Nah, I am who I am, and if people don't like that, it's their problem. Aren't we supposed to be working on this paper?
Okay. Why aren't we in love?
We are. Don't you love me?
Yeah.
So?
You know.
Here, do you want to hold my hand?
No, not really.
That's what I thought.
Why aren't we in a relationship?
We are.
Why aren't we in a sexual relationship?
Are you asking why we don't have sex?
Yeah.
Do you want to have sex with me?
No, it's just too messy. Look at those two. No. No.
Sex is fun. You're weird.
Or it's something to get unhealthy attention.
Thanks, Mom.
I bet I make a great mom.
You gotta have sex to do that.
Nuh-uh. I'm a godparent. Just ask them Kathy and give it a boo.
You're terrible.
People tell you all the time when you're younger that being different is a good thing. Stand out, shine, be yourself. All of us have been force-fed these Pollyanna-esque bumper sticker quotes since before we can remember. But if you look closer, I think we can all see that that's a lie. They, whomever they are, have a pretty strict definition of what it means to be different. Please, by all means, get a stupid haircut, dance while nobody's looking, be a theater kid, or buy a fedora, and have us all make fun of you behind your backs, but the second you're actually different, the second you challenge all the centuries of BS standards in any big, real way, you're a pariah. I realized my mom was different when I was 7. It was after school and I'd been bullied that day because I told the class that my mom was a time traveler. When you're young, sometimes you trust what your parents say just because they're your parents and you haven't been around long enough to be forced into realizing the painful permanence of reality, so I thought they were telling the truth. I was very proud of her, getting inspiration for her poems from all over space-time. My friends, however, teased me for believing her. They said that she was joking and that obviously time travel didn't exist. When I came home and confronted her, she just shut down. She started shaking her head and saying no, 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 over and over again. And that's when Dad had to take me in the other room and explain to me about her condition. He told me not to say anything and that Mom just thinks differently than we do. Hello?
Okay, so I don't want to be all, you know, but like, what the hell is wrong with your cousin?
Hi, Karen. What do you mean?
Slut, obviously. God, it like hung in the air.
Yeah. Hey, I gotta go. I have a dinner in not too long.
Your cousin gonna be there?
Maybe.
Look, why don't you just tell him?
Tell him what?
That he's an ass and he needs to stop.
I can't do that, Karen.
Wow, some feminist you are. Look, someone needs to stand up to him.
And how'd that go for you today?
Wow.
Did you just hang up on me? Didn't know we were still 12.
Yeah, what is it?
Hey, your dad let me in.
What are you doing here?
Well, my brother had brought me a treat, and I needed someone to share.
Dude, you're gonna get me in trouble.
Oh, come off it. Your sister's at your mom's for the weekend, and you know your dad will be totally stoked for you to have a girl in here for a while.
Yeah, but...
What? You're just gonna sit here and play video games all night?
So, yeah, it's not much, but...
But it's home?
Well, yeah, I guess so. One of two. My dad's place is a bit bigger.
I think it's lovely.
Well, thanks. It's not Deer Hills or anything.
Jesse Amos is from Deer Hills.
Oh, cool.
Jesse Amos is a dick.
So, are you from Harmon or...
Oh, no. Much farther. I don't know anyone in the program, really.
Oh! So, how do you know Jesse Amos?
I don't. I just know things. I pay attention. Is that your brother's room down there?
What? Oh, yeah.
It's a nice shade of green on its walls, isn't it?
Do you know my brother, or...?
Sorry, I don't mean to be strange. Yeah, I know your brother. We've been in the program a while now. He's very funny.
Oh.
But that doesn't mean we can't be friends, though. I'm so glad you asked me to come over.
Right, right. Study group. Here, let me go.
Well, that's quite all right.
No, really, it's not. We're not sloths, I promise. It's just, you know, we have a lot of people over all the time. My mom's always working.
Shh. What's the point of a house if it's not lived in?
Oh. Okay. So. I just, again... Thanks for coming over. I'm trying to make sure I keep making friends.
Yeah, my dad said if I went independent, I'd become a hermit.
That's the same reason my therapist told me I should invite someone over this week. You're kind of an assignment.
Well, I admire your honesty.
Thanks.
It's not easy to admit something like that, that you're strange.
Oh, I don't mean to be rude. I've had loads of specialists and therapists on me. I've been told I'm quite strange myself.
If you didn't figure that out, you might be stupider than I thought.
No, I kind of guessed. Plus, I've heard the stories.
What, that I'm crazy?
No, I understand. I don't judge. Trust me.
That's what everyone says at first.
Well, I hope I can be an exception. You can eat that, by the way.
Huh?
The apple, you've been playing with it for the past hour.
Oh, no, I don't want it.
It's okay.
I said I'm not hungry.
Never?
Never. He barely made out with me, let alone get down my pants.
I don't believe it. I've seen the way that boy acts. Kid's a perv. I don't care what you say.
Maybe he was just too young.
This was freshman year. Boys are definitely horny by then.
Right? And I was like all over him, desperate to lose the V card before sophomore year. I guess that is why I did kind of end up cheating on him.
Maybe you are a slut.
I mean, I still don't really like the word, but if I were a guy and said something about wanting to get laid, nobody would bat an eye. So I don't really have a problem being a slut. Can't Jesse Amos just be an ass? Why do we have to dedicate so much of our time to talking about him?
Because gossip is fun.
Y'all are such girls.
Ouch, I'm hurt, Al.
Wounded, even.
Oh, babe, you know I didn't mean it.
I don't, you know, I'm starting to think I don't want to have sex ever either.
Is that so?
Yep, no sex for you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Get a room.
You're just too straight for us.
Whatever. I had a really great story for you guys, but no.
Come on, tell your stupid story.
It's just, the dude's really weird, okay? I mean, he was actually really sweet to me. He left public school a lot earlier than I did. I guess his ice skating career took off, and maybe that made him cocky. But I straight up told him I wanted to have sex, and he kept saying things like, oh, we should wait, or I want it to be the right time, and all that.
Could he have been, like, religious or something?
I mean, I guess his family was, but who does that really stop? And I was, like, really trying, you know? And the more I did, the more withdrawn he got, and eventually I called him out on it, and he was like, if you just want to sleep around, then maybe we should take a break.
Well, that backfired for him, didn't it?
Yeah. So we took a break, and I ended up hooking up with some guy I met at a party. And when I told him, he didn't reply for, like, a week. And then finally he said, we should talk. So we made plans to cut class and meet up in 700 Hall by that big wide window on the second floor that looked out over the whole courtyard. I told Coach Traeger I was having lady issues, and of course that immediately got me out of class. So I ran to the hall and up the stairs, and there he was. Just staring out the window. Like he was concentrating on something. And I didn't really know what to say to him. So I just stared with him. Until he said, I can't. And walked away.
That's it?
What do you mean that's it?
Oh, nothing. Cool story, bro.
Isn't that weird?
Yeah, so crazy.
Maybe he was like asexual or something.
Maybe you're just too ugly.
Thanks.
What? You're too pretty for your own good. Someone needs to knock you down a few pegs.
Wow.
I'm just saying, it's not uncommon to be rejected. Get used to it.
Says the girl making out with her significant other to the single girl.
Says the slut who can get laid whenever she wants.
Says the girl who is obviously jealous.
Please, if I wanted you, I could have you.
Is that so?
Hey, dude, back off my girlfriend.
Hey, dude, your girlfriend's flirting with me.
No, I'm just stating facts. Humor is the most attractive trait a person can have. Egg roll, I'm clearly the sexiest one here and could have whomever I wanted.
Did you just say egg roll?
I believe it's pronounced ergo.
I'm hilarious.
fine. But you are still a very nice gentleman, Reggie Barnes.
Thanks. Too bad these Imperial troops aren't nice guys. Goddamn, it's like the devs want you to hate them.
Has Laura texted you yet?
Nope. Of course not.
You're too good for her.
Oh, thanks. God, whenever I talk about like crushes and stuff to my guy friends, they're always like, oh my god, you're being such a girl and all that crap, you know?
Well, you're not emotionally stunted like most guys, and I think the right girl will see that in you.
Do you really think so?
I know so.
You're a real bro. You know that, Care?
I know. The world is so cool, horrible, terrible place to live in, you know?
Yeah, it is.
The moment when everything changed. Or how an Olympic athlete does his homework in the mirror because he's too busy training and going to stupid family dinners. Okay, so, when did things change? Do the first time I went skating, but it's too obvious. Laura. It's gotta be Laura, doesn't it? Her shoes. Her stupid goddamn shoes.
Honey, what's wrong with your shoes?
What? Nothing, Mom. God, were you holding your ear to the door again?
What? Well, hurry up, Jesse. We're gonna be late.
I'm coming.
Can I read this to you?
Sure.
When I was 5, we traveled cross country. My dad was in the Marines and he had annual service, so we were from Connecticut, where I grew up, to California. It was a long drive and it was hot in the car and very boring, so my brother invented this game where his feet were characters and stories he'd tell. And he'd lie in the way back of the car and put his feet up on the back of the seat, and he'd make them talk to one another. Each time the feet were different characters and stories he'd tell that helped pass the time. When my brother turned 16, my dad was trying to get a new job, and so he wasn't home a lot, and my mom was so involved in taking care of me and my sister that I think my brother felt left out of things. So he stopped talking to all of us. Eventually, he started getting into trouble, and one day he got arrested for stealing something from a store, which was stupid because he stole stuff all the time and he never got caught, so I think he wanted to get caught so my dad would pay attention. My dad did pay attention. He was so mad that he asked the police to keep my brother in jail overnight, and at the last minute he changed his mind, and my brother came home and my dad hit him with a belt. It was bad, and there was a lot of yelling, and eventually my brother just left the house. A month ago, I turned 16, and recently I realized that, like, for the last year, my mom has been saying things to me about my clothes and what I wear because I seem to be calling attention to myself. I told her I am calling attention to myself, and I do want people to pay attention, because when people look at me, it makes me feel like I'm here, and if you have kids, you should pay attention to them so that they feel loved. Most of the time, the world is sharp and jagged and uncomfortable. And without the love and attention of the people around you, it can be a hard place to live in. My brother knew we were bored and miserable in the back of that car, and he tried to make things better. So when I get dressed, I think of who I might be and the possibilities. And I'm inspired by a belief in who I'll become. So why shouldn't I dress the way I feel?
Yeah. glad you could all meet Jane tonight.
Yet another upgrade for Freddy.
Yep, and this one's got brains, unlike the last two.
And much hotter, too. Up top, Freddy.
Yes, exactly. She's just not here because women are objects, right?
Sure. Can you pass the potatoes, please? Thank you.
All right, I have to pee.
Make sure you use the right restroom. You might be an ice skater, but you're still a man. Get it? Because the restroom thing. Too many damn liberals at this table. You know, Jesse's actually quite well with the figure skating.
Yeah?
Oh, yes. Carter has had him on a rigorous training regimen, building muscle and all that. Not enough, if you ask me. He has to stay light, Lloyd. You know this. It's a different kind of muscle. Anyways, they're working on finding him a new partner. He gets to skate with all sorts of pretty girls.
Ha! Maybe I should be a figure skater.
Ha! Nice. Hey, Owen! Hey, Owen! Does your daughter have any extracurriculars yet?
She's right there. You can ask her.
Hey, shit!
I write poetry, like my mom.
Oh, Lord, not another one. No control over her, Owen. You've got to protect her. Shouldn't you at least be trying to keep her from ending up like that psycho wife?
You say one more thing about my mom and I swear to God I will stab this straight through your freaking jugular, you hear me? You, Uncle Freddy and his infinite wives, not to mention all of the women in between or the abortions you paid some of them to get. You, standing by and even encouraging your husband's abuse of you and your kids. Which brings me back to this big fat alcoholic, wielding every amount of power you have over people to compensate for what you know is a miserable, useless existence. And yet, you sit around talking about how my mom is crazy. My mom was accepting and caring and kind and everything that this family isn't. So who gives a shit if she thought she was from the future? Who cares if she heard a few voices? I'd like to see any of you go one day with all that information spinning around in your heads. You weaklings would kill yourselves a million times faster, I guarantee it. But you'll never know that. You'll never care or sympathize with anyone. You don't know me, let alone anyone slightly different than yourselves. You miserable pigs. Your kind should be wiped from existence.
Oh yes, Carter has had him on a rigorous training regimen, building muscle and all that. Not enough if you ask me. He has to stay light, Lloyd, you know this. It's a different kind of muscle. Anyways, they're working on finding him a new partner. He gets to skate with all sorts of pretty girls.
Ha! Maybe I should be a figure skater.
Ha! Nice. Hey, Owen! Hey, Owen! Does your daughter have any extracurriculars yet?
She's right there, you can ask her.
Hey, shit!
I have to pee.
Don't worry, I'm in the right restroom.
No control over Owen. So what happens if you knock up the first chick you meet?
What are you doing here?
I don't know. What could I possibly be doing in my room? What are you doing here?
Nothing. Nothing.
What are you freaking out, dude? You got my underwear on there?
Screw you!
Hey, I mean, I wouldn't be mad!
Shut up!
You can't pretend forever.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
That night at the party?
I was drunk.
Look, I'm offering you the same space.
I was drunk. I didn't know what I was saying. It was a dare.
I support you, but I
don't even remember what I said.
Okay, that's bullshit, and we both know it. Whatever. You want to talk? I'm here.
It's hard, okay?
Nobody said it would be easy.
Do you want to help or do you want to be a bitch?
Cool.
No, Shay, wait.
Yes?
Can you...
Spit it out, Jess.
Can I have a hug?
Yes. Of course you can have a hug.
Thank you.
but I couldn't really hear him. And all together, it went like this.
What's up, slut?
That was not
Karen. Karen, are you okay?
What?
Are you okay?
Oh, sure. Did you hear Jesse?
No.
What did he say? Reggie asked. And I said, huh? Oh, nothing. Forget it. I just let it slide. We all just let it slide. Sure, some of us spoke up quietly, but those same exact people were chilling with him at lunch like it wasn't even a big deal. So how has this changed me? Well, for one, I don't plan on taking anyone's crap anymore. I'm gonna do something about it. Which brings me to number two. I've been doing some serious soul searching recently.
Oh my god, guys, soul searching.
At least I don't lug my camera around so that everybody knows I'm a pretentious filmmaker.
I'm not pretentious, you're the one talking about soul searching.
Miss Adam, can you please get them to shut up?
Al, you're incredibly pretentious, ask your friends.
True.
Thank you. So I've been doing some serious soul searching recently, and I've realized that the world is just a terrible place. We all accept that. Yeah, of course, the world sucks. Generation after generation. We need to start speaking up. To the person in this room, our unnamed predator, I say this. What she did to that girl was belittling, predatory, and completely not okay. Number two, we need to educate people. So here are some facts. 81% of women experience sexual harassment in a verbal form, and 44% experience unwanted touching and sexual advances. And 1 in 6 women have been victims of an attempted or completed rape in her lifetime. Which brings me to my final point and exactly why I want to get to college. By becoming a lawyer, I hope to defend women everywhere to stand out and fight, and not just to be a complacent mind who accepts the world for all of its suck. I hope your college can make that dream come true. Thank you.
So, Karen, that was a bit of an attack, don't you think?
I will not apologize for fighting for change, Miss M.
Right. So, those are some terribly dark statistics. The world is a grim place, which is why I would encourage all of you to put out love as much as possible. Remember, you never know what the person you're talking to is going through. That rhymed. You gotta enjoy the little things, okay? Does anyone else want to share how their essays are coming along? Christy?
Devon wants to share hers.
Devon? All right, where's yours? My mom has breast cancer. Her doctors say it's not too bad, she won't need surgery, but she has to do chemo. She says it's not too bad. She can handle it. My mom is very strong. You know that quote from Rocky VI? It's not about how hard you can hit, it's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. She can take hits, that woman, and she's always moving forward. We fight a lot. We fight over just about anything at all. Like, we'll be driving somewhere and she'll say something stupid, or I'll say something stupid and we'll just go at each other. My dad doesn't say much. I don't think he knows what to say. Lately, my mom and I don't even bother trying to resolve anything. We just stop talking. Last week, we got into an argument about her chemo. Like, what do I know about chemo? We started fighting last year when one day I was getting ready to go to school and I was dressed pretty much the way I am right now, and my mom said, what are you doing? And I said, going to school. And she said, not like that, you're not. And I said, why? And we just looked at each other and she didn't say anything, but I knew what she was thinking. So I just kept looking at her in her eyes, and then I picked up my bag and I went to school. Another time we got into a fight because I said I thought the point of life was to be happy, and she said no, and she just smiled at me like I was a baby or something and said the point of life is not about being happy. And so I asked her, what is it then? What are we supposed to do? What are we supposed to be? But she didn't have an answer, and she just told me to stop yelling at her, and that was the end of it. Now, I know she's had a hard time of it. Like, when she was younger, she was super smart, and a lot of people treated her like she was a nerd, and her dad died when she was pretty young, so she had to take care of her own mom, and she was dying from skin cancer. And then she got married and had to take care of us, so I kind of understand why she thinks the point isn't to be happy, but she made things different for us, and that's what I was trying to tell her. I was trying to say that all her effort had made things so that we can be happy. And I just wanted to know if that's what she wanted, but I guess it didn't come out that way. Anyway, a couple of nights ago after dinner, my sister and I were doing the dishes while my mom and dad sat at the table. My dad sat with my mom so she wouldn't feel bad about being too tired to get up. My sister was telling us about some theory of the universe that says there are multiple parallel universes that operate next to ours. Now in this one, we could all be alive doing the dishes, and in another, we could all be dead. And then everyone got quiet, and the water was still running, and I could hear the wooden chairs my parents were sitting in creak and snap as they shifted in position. And my dad and I looked at each other, and I looked at my sister, and I could tell she'd realized what she'd said. So I went over to her and said, "Jen, that's amazing. It's so cool how you remember all this stuff. So how many lives can we have?" And she said she wasn't sure, but she could show me the clip on YouTube where the guy talks about it. So we headed off towards her room to watch. And as we started to go, my mom suddenly got up out of her chair and she came over to me and she put her hand on my arm and she looked at me. And she was still woozy from all the medication, but it was definitely my mom in there. And she reached up slowly and touched my shoulder and then my hair, and then my cheek, and she looked at me and said, "You look good, babe."
Excellent work, Devon. Thank you for being so vulnerable with us. Does anyone else have any observations or,
That quote is actually really zen. The Rocky one sums the message actually.
Wait, don't you mean Ken? Pretty sure it's Ken, little one.
No, it's Zen.
Hey, if you don't mind, can I actually hear that drive set bit about the Zen thing?
For camera?
Yeah, it won't take long. I swear I'm not a creep or anything.
Yeah, okay. Ow. What's the word for?
It's just out.
Oh, I like it. Right, I'll break the move.
Hey, so did you ask about the sleepover?
No, not yet. Okay, look, I don't even want to go.
Jess!
What? It's not
I'm not letting you back down again. You flip-flops every day this week.
Just not right now. Okay? I'll text you about it tonight.
Yeah, you will.
Hi.
Hi.
I just left something on my chair.
Actually,
got it.
Can I talk to you for a second?
I'd really rather
not. No, it's not what you think it's about. I want to talk to
you. I can't imagine a single thing that you and I would have to talk about, Jesse. Have a good one.
That was an intense class today.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, good for Karen, though. The damn bones and tape.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, let's do it. Let's have sex. You offered, now I want to.
Go away. Sorry. So what were you saying about class today?
Nothing, just sparks flew or whatever.
Well, what did you expect? Dude picks battles with everybody. It's about time somebody picked one back.
But didn't you notice how he was staring at his desk the whole time?
Probably realized he was outnumbered.
Or he had something else going on.
Oh, come on.
Just saying.
That's a classic bully excuse. Hidden pain makes me exempt from being an asshole.
But even if you were, people would understand, at least a little bit.
So, how do you know he's got something going on?
Intuition.
Women's?
Stop! Everyone's got something else going on. What's that, Miss M say? You never know what the person you're talking to is going through. Some real talk right there.
And did you guys hear that? You never know what the person you're talking to is going through, crap. Like, okay, thanks for the tip. She's just a bad teacher.
So awful.
We should have her fired.
We should have her executed.
Off with her head.
That's not what
I'm saying. And the king. I always feel so bad for that dude.
Because she's so huge and he's so tiny.
No, mostly just because he's, like, pathetic.
athletic, but that's a good point, actually. He's animated to be, like, knee height on her, so how does that, like, work out for them?
I mean, most Disney relationships don't make sense.
Yeah, like, okay, is Peter Pan a pedophile or not? Because he's been in Neverland for, like, really long. And I know he's not growing up, but he's got to be at least, like, 40 by the time he kidnaps
Peter Pan's,
him.
Like, a whole other level.
Are neither of you bothered by what happened in class today?
No.
Are you sure you're not just upset because we told you you were pretentious?
I'm not. It's not just that, okay? She had her nose in her phone the whole period. We only meet one day a week. She has us reading essays out loud that she's gonna have to read alone later anyways. Half the class isn't paying attention. And then she lets some rich bitch attack Jesse Amos for a whole period and insults me for making a few jokes.
Yeah, it hurts when you get burnt, but you'll survive this one.
That's not the point.
Guys, I was getting to the point, listen.
Oh, shut up. It's just, none of us can take the class seriously. Even she can't pay attention for one day a week. Why should we even write her stupid papers? We are not learning anything. We're just typing up words, going through pointless motions to one day receive a piece of paper declaring us not completely stupid.
I mean, she's still gonna grade them and give critique and stuff. And you do learn from practice. Even you should wanna work on writing, you know, since you write screenplays.
Whatever, play a little game. I'm gonna create something I actually care about.
Oh, whatever, I'm Al. I'm an enlightened artist. No one understands me.
The world is rigged. It's all a lie. Everybody's out to get me. I hate you guys.
Whatever, you love us.
Jeez! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10! Damn it! Stop calling me mean!
No, you! This is weird! Stop reading my brain!
You guys are fine.
5 stars!
Oh,
damn!
Yeah.
Oh.
So, you said you had something to show us, right?
Oh, yeah. Here, check this out. I've been editing. It's not as good as I would like, but...
Okay, keep on watching.
No, I looped it. And that's all real too. She didn't even try to do that, just smack right into the ground.
I feel the love.
So, have either of you guys started out on this assignment yet? The moment when everything changed. What does that even mean?
The moment when everything changed.
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 Same moment, then everything changed.
This is pointless.
How are people done with their essays already?
Karen's essay though, am I right? Jesse Amos.
Is a world-class piece of trash. He deserved it.
Right? And we all know guys like that. Tell me you don't know at least 5 other guys exactly like that.
At least.
And that's what I'm saying. Karen's right. All girls do. You know Tina Fey?
Oh, I love Tina Fey!
Right, so when she was adapting Mean Girls, her and the author of the book went to this women's conference thing, right?
Okay.
Okay, so then at the conference, they did this thing where they asked everyone about the moment they knew they were a woman, right? Okay, so then everyone started talking about getting catcalled, something like that, and only 2% were like graduating college or something.
I believe it.
And it's been that way for years, just assholes like Jesse Amos, future Olympic gold medalist.
You know he's been arrested twice for driving under the influence.
You serious?
Yup.
And got off scot-free because his family can afford a big-time lawyer, no doubt.
Probably. But he's also a member of Olga's Ice World GQ subscriber and shattered an elbow in the 5th grade.
You sure know a lot about Jesse Amos.
I stole his wallet one time.
Wait, what?
I told you I was strange.
Wait, but was there like a diary in that wallet or...
Oh! No, but it's amazing what you can find with an address, a driver's license number, and a social security card, which you really shouldn't have in his wallet, because I mean, if I can get to it in a whole break period, then... Oh no, you think I'm strange.
No, no! Okay, a little, but I kind of think you're badass.
Hardly.
So who else have you snooped on?
Kind of everyone. Your brother has a picture of you in his wallet, which is cute. But he also has a picture of Daisy Ridley in a swimsuit.
That boy needs to get laid.
It tends to mess with the guy's brain, in my opinion.
So, you're like a spy?
Most would say stalker.
It doesn't count as stalking, Stavril. That's just awesome.
I like knowing stories. You always have something on everyone just in case.
Dude, you're like a beautiful, evil genius.
This is the opposite reaction I usually get.
I tend to be the opposite of what people want from me.
I think that's a good thing. It was at cheer practice.
What?
It was at JV cheer practice, and I went to the bathroom, and Brad Timms was there on break from football, and he pushed me up against the wall, felt up my skirt. I pushed him away, and he said I was too fat anyways. The moment I first felt like a woman by Laura Gardner.
Wow. Are you okay?
No, but who is?
You've had a messed up life, haven't you?
Pretty much.
Me too.
Want to talk about it?
Not at all.
Maybe that's why we're strange. I've never told anyone that story before.
Well, I'm honored, I guess. I can't believe you were a cheerleader.
I've been rehabilitated.
Is that why? I don't mean to pry, but is that?
Yeah.
Is he why you don't like to eat?
Hey, Dana, Laura, is Reggie here? I tried calling him, but he didn't pick up.
I don't know. He might be at my dad's.
Well, it's kind of urgent. He has my wallet because I literally have like no pockets on his outfit. Can't drop without my license.
So. I'll go check his room.
Thank you. You're the best.
I hate that, not having pockets. Like, guys have them everywhere.
I didn't ask you.
I'm sorry. Have I offended?
You're no good for him.
Oh. Reggie.
Wow. I'm surprised you even know his name. Good for you.
I don't think you...
I don't want to hear it. Look, you heard me today. I'm tired of being walked all over. Look, Reggie's a great guy. He may not be the most normal dude in the world, but he's a sweetheart, and you don't even get to answer his freaking text messages.
I just don't,
okay? You and I both know that he needs someone more stable than Luna Laura, so just let him down easy, okay? It's how hanging around his sister. It's creepy. You just toy people for the hell of it? Is that just what you do? Yeah, run from your problems, real mature.
So, yeah, he's not here. Probably at Dad's. There's horrible reception there, so... Hey, where's Laura?
Oh, she just kinda left. You know her, super weird.
Did she say anything?
No,
or?
Not really. Totally her, though, right? I'll catch you later. Gotta go.
Oh. Okay.
Hello?
Hello?
Anyone home?
Mom, Dad, Tony?
Hello?
Anyone?
Didn't think
so. Of course not.
Hey, Shelly. Yeah.
Wait a minute,
man. I know, it's been a while.
Yeah, I was wondering.
Yeah.
What? Oh, a game tonight.
2 years.
Oh, no. I.
Wow.
Well, I don't really want to see
yeah.
Coach. Well, he
what?
Just hassled me.
No.
Oh.
No, I haven't been in the hospital.
No,
so
no, I just tell the team
yeah.
I said.
Oh, yeah.
No, you do that. We'll catch up some other time.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you too.
You too.
Bye.
Thank you.
hurt you. I just here.
Get away from me!
Okay, well let me get you a ride. You can't drive.
No, I'm fine.
Okay, well here, just come.
No! Get away! Move!
And when you watch it, you die in 7 days. So then Naomi Watts accidentally lets her son watch it, so her and her ex-husband-
I'd rather not. Dude, you've got your nose in the book anyways.
It's not even that scary. It was made in like 2002.
No, I can deal with a horror movie, and I don't want to get in the way of what you guys want to do. I just prefer if you avoided excess gore and divorce.
Oh my god.
Tara.
No, are you hearing this? Is this not bothering you?
They've got From Dusk Till Dawn.
Really? You're just letting them censor what we get to watch.
There are plenty of other movies.
Is there something you'd like to say to me, Tara?
Yes. You need to quit being a little baby about things. Plenty of people's parents are divorced. You can't just be sensitive to the topic forever.
You've been through a lot, Tara. People probably don't tell you that enough. Losing your dad to cancer sucks. You have my love, sympathy, and-
What? What is this? Don't condescend to me. Is this one of that stupid Zen crap?
You have my love, sympathy, and support. But that does not give you permission to be cold and apathetic just because you think you suffered more than anyone else.
More than you? Look at this place. Look at your life. Most people would kill to be you. You have your whole dream career set up. You want to sell that plan.
I'm grateful for what I have. I know this. But suffering is relative, and we can't deny ourselves our
dream. Either way, it doesn't matter more or less. All that matters is I was able to get over my suffering like an adult.
And what do you think I'm doing? Why do you think I'm reading the Zen?
Okay, but
what about what makes me happy?
What?
Moment that changed my life. My dad said that when they were telling us about the divorce. I want my dad to be happy, and I want to be happy too. Sometimes both can't happen. Sometimes what you want doesn't matter.
I don't want anything except maybe for you to not be a little whiner.
Right, but you're just one piece of the grand existence. And every individual has things and needs that make them happy. Sometimes you have to just abide others.
The hue abides, eh? So like, if someone was happy with murder,
don't
then...
pull the murder card. Everything's to an extent. You know that.
Just saying, I had to get through a lot worse, and I didn't make
exactly. Your dad. I'm sorry.
Again with the condescension!
I'm not condescending!
You're condescending.
Okay, maybe a little bit. All I'm saying is that you're just one piece of the grand existence. And yes, you've had to be a damn strong piece of it. But you also get to choose whether you let that make you a bitch, or a more compassionate and understanding human being.
I really hate the new you.
It's kind of insufferable.
Come on, Jess, I don't have all night.
I don't know.
Just get out of here, you look fine.
I am taking this off, all of this off. I cannot believe I let you talk me into this shit. Where is a washcloth?
You didn't even look.
I don't have to, my dad.
Your dad isn't here, Jess, only me.
I look ugly. It's not.
Didn't even look.
It's
just take a look. One look. Just an actual look this time. Oh my god, you're gonna have to look eventually, so just get it over with.
I don't know.
What don't you know?
I mean, there's still me. I've got stubble and.
Well, if you want that to change, then it's
gonna take a while. I know. But in the meantime.
In the meantime, you're still gorgeous.
I don't think so.
Well, that's probably the most female feeling you can have. Tell me honestly,
How do you feel?
Great. I feel great.
I can tell. You can't stop smiling.
Shut up.
If he gets violent or tries to kick you out, you always have a place to stay here.
Really?
Dude, you know my dad. He'd love to have another misfit running around here.
You know, I think that's offensive or something.
What?
You know, calling me a misfit?
Maybe. I think of it more as an unfortunate truth.
What do you mean?
I mean, like, duh. Being the you that you were born to be should make you a misfit, but it just so happens that we live in a shitty time. The world is terrible, or whatever Karen was saying.
Karen?
Sorry.
No. I should be sorry. I hate myself.
That is not helpful.
I know. I just...
You're going through a lot. You've been going through a lot. You've been hiding from yourself. It must have been a personal hell. It's understandable, but guess what?
What?
Not to, like, push you in any direction or anything, but for the past 30 seconds, you've been speaking like you've accepted the fact that you're transgender. Just saying.
It's weird, okay?
I can imagine.
No, it's like, because I've been trying for so hard, for so long to distance myself from being different or whatever.
That's your father talking.
And it doesn't make it any easier to be.
Didn't say it was, but here's the cool thing about being a misfit in a time like this. It might change a few minds.
Not his.
I mean, you're his daughter, you never know.
Daughter?
What?
It feels good, right? I don't know.
I'm glad. Let's watch a movie.
This is not a horror movie. War of the Worlds scared enough people in 1938.
Exactly, 1938, and with Orson Welles, not Tiny Tom Cruise and Dakota Crying.
How long have you been sitting on those?
A few minutes.
Sure. I'm gonna miss this. What's that supposed to be? I think I'm gonna come out to my parents. I mean, October 11th is National Coming Out Day, so...
So what?
So I doubt they'll go for the whole sleepover thing anymore.
Damn. Well, I'm proud of you.
That's bull! Such an insignificant thing shouldn't be such a big deal.
Yeah, well, a lot of things shouldn't be such a big deal.
I like to hope they won't be eventually. I mean, we can push and fight all we want, but in the end, we're just one person. Even hundreds and thousands of people rally for change. But either way, humanity just happens to progress at a depressingly slow rate. That's just how it is.
Lovely.
Well, at least it's progress, right?
Can't tell if you're an optimist or a pessimist.
You can do that, right?
What?
Lift people. Your mom said you'd be doing partner work.
Oh, yeah, right.
You okay?
It's just, you know, ice skating queer. How cliche, right?
Who cares? You're you. Personally, I think people spend way too much time trying to be different. I think we'd be a lot happier if we talked about how similar we all are.
You should be a motivational speaker.
Nah. I can call the world out on its shit, but I'm not so good at, like, doing anything about it.
You know, I hate lifting people.
Really? That looks exciting.
I mean, maybe for her, but for him, it's kind of scary. I mean, you've got this life in your hands, and when it's ice under you and not a lady, if you mess up, she dies, and nobody wants that job.
You want to be her.
Whenever I watch this stupid movie, whenever I lift those girls, always.
Well, I can help you with the hair and makeup, but I've got, like, zero muscle in these arms, so...
Oh, please. Like I trust you with this body?
Whatever. So, are you gonna stick with Jesse?
I haven't made any decisions yet, Shay.
Okay.
I don't know if I can handle the process of it all, you know?
Weaker girls than you have survived, and most come out much happier. Did you ever tell anybody?
No. I mean, I barely knew myself, or let myself know, I guess. When I was little, I used to have dreams about being a girl, but after a while, they just kind of died down. You know, come to think of it, I did almost tell June, actually.
June? Seriously?
Yes, yes. So, we dated in freshman year. We went to the same high school before all this, and she always wanted to have sex, and I didn't want anything to do with it. And right before we broke up, I was gonna tell her why, but I'd spent so long thinking that it was wrong. I didn't know what I was thinking, you know?
I think that should tell you something.
Jesse reminds me a lot of my dad, but I like Jess, so maybe Jessica.
Jessica, I like that.
What time is it? Oh my god, guys. Guys, guys, wake up.
What time is it?
It's like 3, it doesn't matter, wake up.
No.
June, hey, June, wake up.
I hate you.
Hey, come on, guys, wake up. This is good, okay? I've got a way for us to get out of this stupid assignment.
How? Don't listen to Al, nothing is important after 2 a.m.
I'm listening, hun. I support you in all of your ventures.
I hate you both.
Okay, we make an independent film.
What? Weren't you just saying how pretentious you're not?
Shut up! It could be cool, like Jim Morrison pre-Doors or George Lucas pre-Star Wars, all avant-garde.
Hun, I love you, but you're not helping your case.
Who cares if it's a little pretentious? Not Miss M on her phone the whole class. I bet she doesn't even read the essays.
But she still wants essays, not videos.
If it's good enough, it doesn't matter. We'll stand out. What's one English assignment really gonna do to your grade anyways?
Aren't we already in the middle of a short film?
Our short film sucks. We had no idea what we were doing. We can't salvage some of the audio, but this... Oh, this will be so much easier because we can actually probably, we can probably use some of our outtakes in the short too. Man, I gotta plan this all out. Where's my notebook?
Can you please tell them to shut up or I'm going to kill them tomorrow?
Don't worry, I'm right there with you.
Bad night, huh?
Yeah.
Wanna talk about it?
Maybe not yet.
Fine. You're still eating, right?
Enough? Probably not.
Let's get some food to you then.
Why aren't you angry?
I'm very familiar with bad nights. Happens to the best of us.
You're a good friend.
Thanks. You too.
I've never been a good friend to anyone. I don't want anything to mess it up.
I know my brother has a thing for you.
No, I'm not good for him.
Shut up!
Wait. Shh.
Let's get some food.
Yeah. Thanks for not being angry.
Just got back from Illinois. Locked the front door, oh boy. Got to sit down, take a rest on the porch. Imagination sets in. Pretty soon I'm singing. Do, 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 looking out my back door.
You want any more of this thing? It's almost out.
I'm not a good dude.
Ow! Goddamn stupid thing.
That's good, dude. It's just weed.
Easy for you to say. You didn't buy it.
Yeah. I'm actually thinking of not buying for a while, actually.
What are you talking about?
I don't know, I've been doing a lot of thinking recently.
Doing some soul searching with
Aaron. No, not exactly. Not like that.
You tell.
Okay, so she came over last night.
I bet she came over.
Can I tell one story without an interruption? Okay, thank you. So Karen comes over and she has this bottle of vodka that her brother got her, and then she's like all sprawled out on my bed and like she's got both of us drunk.
Oh my god! You had sex! Good
no,
for you!
No, that's the point. I didn't realize that she wanted to have sex with me until the morning after at breakfast.
Oh god. Your awkwardness. It hurts.
I know.
Wait, but didn't you say Karen was like your sister?
Yeah, but that was like before she wanted to have sex with me, you know?
Wow. So now that you know she wants to have sex with you, suddenly you're interested? You gotta think better of yourself, dude.
I know. Well, precisely. Hence why I believe I need to smoke less weed and play less video games. Like, I just plain don't feel like I'm interesting enough. Like this is my life now.
We're interesting. We're doing things.
We're smoking weed in my backyard.
And philosophizing and enjoying the sun.
Okay, fine. But like, think about it. Like, what if I was actually out there in the real world? Like meeting new people and like learning new things, like gathering knowledge. I don't know. Maybe that would be interesting enough for like the really cool girl, you know?
Dude, Karen is so much better than Crazy Eyes.
I don't know. Karen's a little too much.
And Laura isn't?
Well, Laura's a different kind of too much. I don't know. Actually,
you
think
and Laura are never gonna happen, okay, dude? She's not good for
you. How do you know that?
Because I do, okay? She's not normal. She's not stable, dude.
Okay, whatever. Maybe I don't like normal.
She'd be with someone else in a second. All she cares about is herself.
How could you possibly
I just do, okay? She's just like that. Wild child or whatever.
Whatever, just because she dresses a little-
I literally slept with her last night.
What?
Well, like, don't take it the wrong way.
How am I supposed to take that?
Well, you know, we were at a party.
But you hate her!
Yeah, but we were both drunk and we knew each other.
You've known I've had a crush on her for like a year!
Well, yeah, and like, where has it gotten you? I mean, I probably saved you, dude. You should have seen all the people she was grinding on last night. You don't wanna fight me, dude.
I hate you!
No, you don't.
You've got everything! Everyone has a crush on you. You're so goddamn good at everything. I hate it and I hate you.
Tell me how you really feel.
Get out of my house.
Well, we're in your backyard, so we're technically outside of your house.
Leave.
Look, I'm sorry, but I think you're overreacting.
Can you just go?
Is that what you really want?
Yes!
Okay, fine. See you around, Reg.
Go to hell.
Jesse?
Come on up.
So the day that changed my life is a day that we all remember, and it's a day a few of us probably don't want to talk about.
Then maybe don't talk
about it. Hey, this is a safe place. Let him talk.
It wasn't a safe place.
I said let him talk, Karen.
Thanks, Ms. Anna. Okay, look. I understand why you're all angry at me. I've been an ass.
Hey.
I know. I've been so horrible to all of you for so long, and this isn't an excuse. I don't want to win you over or win your sympathy or anything. I don't know. I hope that maybe you'll understand where I'm coming from. Okay, so that got your attention. The day that changed my life was the day one of our classmates was taken away in an ambulance.
Seriously, dude?
Hey.
Shh. I like this story.
You like Oh, okay. So that day, before it all happened, for whatever reason, that classmate decided to talk to me. Now, I don't know why she picked me of all people, and I've thought about it a lot ever since, and I think it must have been because she wanted to find the biggest asshole she could find. Yeah. I think she wanted to be told that she should kill herself. So she came up to me before class, distressed, and she said she was gonna kill herself. And I asked her why, and she said, because I'm disgusting. And all of you know her, and you'd have to be stupid to think that she's disgusting, but something about the world and something in her past and the advertisements and media and comments from people like me had broken her ability to see that. And I think this is where she wanted me to agree with her and to call her, fat or ugly or whatever she expected. But instead, I felt like I wanted to cry.
And it's all about you now.
Ooh. Quiet! We're getting to the good part.
I felt like I wanted to cry because I knew the feeling. And I'd been looking at myself in the mirror since I was 6 and hating it and thinking that I was in a body that wasn't mine. So instead of being what she expected, I tried to touch her on the cheek and tell her she's beautiful. And coming from me, it wasn't taken well. She ran into the bathroom and locked the door, and I pounded on it and screamed for about 2 minutes until very calmly she opened the door and looked at me right in the eyes and said, "I just took 7 sleeping pills and haven't eaten in a week. You should probably call someone." And the EMTs were loading her up and talking about pumping her stomach and all that, and all I could think about was how pretty she was laying there. How cute her outfit was and how cute her shoes were. And her shoes in particular, they stuck with me. I really wanted those shoes.
You can have them.
Okay. And I couldn't stop thinking about it. So that night I got really drunk and I told my cousin how confused I was, and she told me what that meant, and then I went back to denying it for quite a while. But if that hadn't happened, I wouldn't have told anyone. And I needed to tell someone. And I'm glad I did, because here I am now, coming out to all of you. My name's Jessica Amos, and I'm transgender.
You just didn't do it?
Well, I was gonna talk about telling my dad that I was gay, but then Jessica had her thing, and I felt like it was insignificant. I don't know. I got distracted by helping my friend.
I don't mean to be insensitive to your friend, but you did have 3 weeks to do this, and I can hardly imagine you were helping her the entire time.
I just need a C, honestly. Do you have anything to eat in here?
So, what do you think the transition point in your essay was?
I don't know, like, now, I guess? I didn't know what else to write about.
Okay, but more specifically, what happened, what changed?
Well, my brother left, and I realized that I don't want to leave, that all I really need is real love in my life to get by, and it's okay if I ask for that.
I know this sounds strange, but every year I'm surprised to find out just how much some of my students have been through.
I know. I'm so strong because my dad's dead, right?
Tara, a lot of other students have been through similar. I could ask them.
Oh, yay! Then we could all start a group therapy session and sing Kumbaya together. We're done, right?
I really wouldn't beat yourself up over it.
I know, that's what everyone keeps saying, but I had the opportunity to help her, you know?
Jessica hadn't told anyone yet. I mean, for all you knew, she...
I get it, but when someone singles you out like that, specifically you, because you and maybe only you can offer the insider help they need, like, who cares if they're a major douchebag? If I was the only one she was comfortable confiding in, isn't it my obligation to listen?
I can't help but feel like you were a little vague with your conclusion. I mean, you said you want to help people, but what exactly do you want to do?
I don't know, and that's okay. I need to figure out how I best fit in the universe. I want to learn some languages, travel, figure out what's wrong with the world, then do something about it.
How are your parents? How are you holding up with all the...
All the divorce?
Yeah.
Yeah. Things aren't fully settled yet. They still fight. You know, drama. I guess at a certain point I realized adults are just as confused and emotional as the rest of us.
How's your mom doing?
She's fine. Treatments and all, but she's fine.
That's good. Again, thank you for sharing. My fiance actually...
Can I go?
Yeah, but if you ever want to talk, please just...
Nice try, Miss M. I read a poem.
Yeah, but it was for an essay.
Really? That's what you've got to say to me? You're an English teacher and I wrote something beautiful and you know it. Where do you think all the stuff you teach comes from? You have to make it before you can talk about it, right?
Christine, what you wrote is beautiful.
That's it?
That's it. And, well... Look, if this is about what I think it was about, then I really want you to know that this is a safe space, and sexual abuse, it's not something...
It's fine, we'll be away for a while.
Good. And please, keep writing.
I will.
Definitely A-level work. However, I can't help but feel like Laura is a bit of an odd choice.
Why is that?
I guess, you know, you're a good kid, Dana, and I...
And she's not? She's just trying to keep being a better human than she was yesterday, just like the rest of us, Sam.
If you don't get your act together, Miss Gardner, you may not graduate.
Cool.
Look, Laura, I'm not your enemy, and I'm certainly no stranger to mental illness. I really hope that I haven't done anything to make you feel afraid of coming...
I'm not afraid of anything, Miss M. I'm embarrassed. Everyone here has seen me try to kill myself, and people like you love to say things like, "Oh, it's not you, it's mental illness." But it is me. I did it. I do everything I do. I'm accountable for all of it. Do you think that's something fun to reminisce about? Because I don't.
I used to think I don't understand women, but now I just plain don't think I understand relationships. Like did me and Brian break up? Like, is that what it is when it happens to friends?
I think so.
And plus I'm having like this whole romantic crisis. Like, it's obvious I like Laura, right? Because I've liked her for so long, but I don't know, but at the same time, Karen is like,
okay,
right there,
Reggie,
you know?
We were talking about your essay, the first time I played Tetris.
Do you think I would like Karen because I know she'll hook up with me? Wait, no, don't answer that, that's weird, you're a teacher. But I don't know, I just want someone who, like, gets me, you know? Like, but at the same time, like, lets me be myself around them and, like, also makes me a better person, you know? I mean, sex would be pretty great too, but,
I think that most people spend their whole lives
lonely. I'm just so tired of being lonely. Like, I have all these people that I call friends, but they just don't feel like company, you know? Like, I don't know, I guess I just need to, like, get better friends. Like, I just need to meet more people, you know? Like, I need to meet people, like, right now.
Reggie, you can...
I think I'm gonna go.
Little Red. How I lost my best friend in the whole world.
I just miss him, you know? Hanging out with Oreos. I wasn't trying to hurt his feelings. It was just like we didn't even actually sleep together. We almost did, but then she got weird. She's just weird, all up and down all the time. Reggie is way too awkward, inexperienced to deal with something like that, you know?
You thought I'd read about my mom, huh? I mean, I don't blame you. Schizophrenia is fascinating, but... I don't know, I guess that's old news to me. I think I learned more from helping Jessica. I don't know.
Can I offer an observation, Miss Amos?
Sure.
your mom, Jessica. Either way, you're talking about someone else. I know sometimes after trauma it can be easier.
Really blowing my mind here, Ms. M.
You know, you could lose the constant sarcasm. After a while, it just comes off as bitchy. I'm sorry, that was incredibly unprofessional.
No, no. It's probably the realest thing you've ever said to me.
If there's anything I can do for you, please.
Probably not.
Well, just know that you have my full support, okay?
Thanks, Miss M.
Welcome to class, Jessica.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I'm so sorry.
What?
I mean, I said some really bad things and you were kind of a prick, and I don't really know if you still are, but
Karen, it's okay. Like I said, it's not an excuse. I was still an asshole, but maybe we can start over, right? I'm Jessica.
Yeah, nice to meet you, Jessica. I'm Karen.
Cool. Clean slate now, right?
Yeah.
Alright, I'll see you around.
Hello, Karen.
I need to rewrite my essay.
Hey, where is it exactly?
Oh, right. Forgot. Here you go. Press play when you're ready.
Is this a video? We make independent films.
I make independent films. My girlfriend and buddy are just actors.
Okay, you buddy. All know that this is an essay, right?
Yeah, we changed it. It's better this way.
You know, I respect that, but in the workplace,
please,
you can't just change.
Press play. I want this to be over as soon as possible.
So, imagine you're a tree, right?
Okay. Start over.
I get no down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get no down, but I get up again.
This tree is strong. It grows for a while, and then all of a sudden, wham! Storm comes around and knocks it right over. But this time, one of its seeds takes hold, right? And it grows bigger and bigger, and weathers a few times, and almost grows as big as its parent tree. And then whoosh, an even stronger wind, and even stronger. And the trees can get bigger and bigger and more flexible, but still there's always something tougher that can take the tree out.
The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it.
Like, I don't know, everything's shitty. So emo. Like, even things that feel good or seem good, like, have a side that hurts somebody else, you know?
Yeah, but like, there's also so much time that you feel alive or uplifted or whatever. And I mean, I guess either way, it's never permanent, but sometimes we gotta hold out for the good times, right?
You, me, or nobody. He's gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
So, the tree represents your ego, right?
Sure, if you wanna look at it that way. Mostly it's just, there's always change, change is hard.
But only while things are changing.
And we keep building new pasts and getting nostalgic about them and never being happy now.
Sings a song that reminds them of the good time, right. But isn't that also because things are constantly changing in the now?
For everyone, right? And life is so haphazard and random and there's always something crappy happening. But for all we know, it's all we've got. So we just gotta keep on getting back up again, right? And try to embrace it and enjoy it with each other because it's the same shit for everyone.
Wow. You actually know what you're talking about. You know, I never thought students would show me the deep philosophical insights of Chumbawamba. Wait, so this is like good? I mean, I wouldn't go that far. You still all failed to actually do the assignment.
Come on, like you even care.
What have I done to make you think that I don't care, Al?
Showing up late, texting all through class.
Students do that all the time.
Yeah, but you're like a teacher.
I'm sorry if you feel like I've been neglectful of my students, Al. If you all must know, my fiance's actually been in and out of the hospital.
Wait, you're engaged?
Yeah, and she hasn't had a great diagnosis.
I didn't know that you were gay.
I hardly see how that's important. What's important is the quote that you slapped on the front of your video. I believe I said something similar just a few weeks ago. Now, I have felt deeply guilty about being so detached from class, but at the same time, I need to recognize that the love of my life is a little more important than my job.
Got you by balls on that one.
Well,
but it was a good video. It was a good assignment. You all clearly got the point as much as you entirely missed it at the same time. You've got a fat head. And if you applied half the complaining you do, you might really get somewhere.
Is your fiance okay, or?
She should be, but I don't know. It's out of my hands at this point.
I'm sorry.
But you've got taste. I don't see many experimental short films that are both funny and deep. Look, I know you're not planning on going to college,
it's
but
really not
I would remind you that there are scholarships available. Just think about it, okay?
Thanks.
Yeah.
So, what does this mean as far as grading goes? Do Skeeter and I still have to come in tomorrow?
Oh, you actually
wait, you guys actually wrote essays?
It's not that we didn't believe
you.
Because,
see you
like, Advent Garde, like, of
it's,
course,
oh,
girl.
Oh, God.
Advent
I gotta
Garde.
Get going. Okay.
Babe.
Bye,
Miss
Em. Bye.
I don't know about this.
Me either. I don't think anyone does.
Can we sit down?
Hey, Mom? I need to talk to you.
When I was in the third grade, I thought that I was gay, cause I could draw. My uncle was, and I kept my room straight. I told my mom, tears rushing down my face, she's like, baby, don't do